It's one of the world's most iconic musicals. It's one of the best known stories of all time. But did you know, it is also true. Real events, actual characters, unsolved mysteries. The legend of the Opera Coast has been haunting Paris for more than a century. Now, after much research, we are presenting you with the genuine facts. Join us as we uncover the truth behind the mask. Far before Andrew Lloyd Webber created one of the most unforgettable theatre experiences, the crash of the opera's chandelier had already become a much-expected moment in every Phantom adaptation. A trend initiated by the 1925 classic, which Gaston Leroux had gruesomely depicted in his novel, perhaps way too accurate. The majestic bronze chandelier is arguably one of the most recognizable symbols of Palais Garnier. An innovative ornament designed by the architect, it weighs 7,000 kilos, features 340 lights, and cost 30,000 francs to produce. But although this massive piece of engineering is highly admired nowadays, it earned great criticism when it was first installed, since it blocked the view from the highest circles. It was on the 20th of May, 1896, when the infamous event took place. While the audience was enjoying a performance of the opera L.A., some noticed a sudden flash of light on the ceiling. When they looked closer, panic struck. The giant chandelier was swinging. As the alarm was given, people were quickly escorted out of the auditorium. But one of them was just too late. Madame Chaumette was fatally hit by one of the 800 kilos counterweights which had dropped from the chandelier. A concert from a nearby building, this had been her first, and sadly also last, visit to the opera house. The forensics rapidly discovered the source of the misfortune. The huge metal structure was surrounded by electrical wires which provided the power. A short circuit in one of these wires had melted the steel of one of the suspension cables, leading to the horrible incident. Some of France's most prestigious papers covered the unfortunate occurrence, which also scarred the building for more than 50 years. The painting on the ceiling was permanently damaged, and it would not be until 1950 when the restoration, with an entirely new design, would be approved. So, though technically the real chandelier has never fallen, Gaston Leroux's vivid imagination needed nothing else to create the Phantom's signature disaster. One of the many incredible secrets kept within the embellished walls of a theatre so remarkable that even got to be home to some of the most cruel tortures in recent history. But that is another story.